Greetings, everyone. Welcome to our first evening with guitar and harp for the semester. I'm Christopher Ladd, the chair of the guitar and harp program, and I'd like to welcome all of you here and those of you at home. For this fantastic evening, you've got a combination of solo performers, chamber music, guitar and harp, guitar and flute, guitar duet, solo guitar. The only thing missing are 8 more guitars, which just make it 8 times as good. Please feel free to join us at our second evening with guitar and harp Thursday, April 6th, same time, 7:30. The live stream will be the same address here in Berkman Recital Hall. Enjoy the show.
first piece that I'm going to play for you is a movement from Andrew York's Numen Suite. It's titled Menhir. It is, well, the word Menhir, I guess, what it literally means is a large stone monolith, multiple together to make a henge. I don't know what he's trying to say with this, but it does have this, all the pieces throughout have this theme. And I think maybe that could be that stone monolith, and it means something to the person who made it, maybe Andrew York. And he's displaying it to us here. Transcriptions, similar to the first one I played in the fall. They're all of Mexican guitar music from the early 20th century. The recordings that I worked from, he was a guitarist who used a 7-string guitar. Unfortunately, I don't have a 7-string, so we had to adapt a lot of the stuff here. But I think they keep their character, and they have a nice, usually waltz or dance feel to them that I really enjoy. And they're quite infectious. Thank you. So hello again, I'm Emilio, and this is Hamid. We're going to play a piece from Ferdinando Carulli's Six Petit Duos. This is number two. I guess I'll warn you guys now, it's going to end on a half cadence because we're only doing the first movement. So it's going to sound a little, maybe, unresolved. But it's a beautiful piece. It gets to that unresolution in a very beautiful way. Thank you.
playing From the Dreaming by Phillip Houghton. A little bit of Phillip's words about this piece to really describe it. He says that this music was inspired by a 7-month visit to the Australia Central and Northern Outback regions in 1986. It left powerful impressions on me, the searing heat, the isolation and stillness, ancient riverbeds and caves, sudden violent electrical storms, and the red carpet of dust sprinkled with flowers of vibrant yellow, orange, and purple. The Outback is an entire world of iridescent color, a fantastic spiritual and both savage and beautiful, where everything means something and nothing, where the stars at night are only inches from your eyes.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.